Welcome back. Today we are going to talk about, in continuation to what we talked about in our last video regarding the Israel-Hamas ceasefire and the UN Security Council's resolution, where most of the nations were in favor of it and USA was against that particular resolution. They have not agreed to it. They have abstained from that particular resolution. The resolution was regarding ceasefire till the month of Ramadan and releasing of the hostages. Now, the Ramadan has already ended on 11th April 2024. But there were different views by few nations regarding that resolution. So, Professor Khurana, I would like to ask you regarding the view of the Palestinian foreign minister regarding the resolution by UN Security Council, if you can throw some light on their views and how is it going to affect the world at large.
You have picked up this topic in a very timely fashion. Mm-hmm. We have before us that over half a dozen resolutions were passed the last couple of years. You can see against Palestinians and in favor of Palestinians, against Israel mm-hmm. and in favor of Palestinians. Because of the non-binding nature, Israel couldn't care less about them. Hmm. And there was the big rally, US, and small rallies like UK, to support them. Which has become very obvious, irrespective of what stance editorial boards of major media take. Because the time period is on, and nobody will happen. So, if one sees it as a liberal, not even intellectual, if one sees it as a person who would generally like to support human rights rather than destroy human rights, wherever it might happen. Yes, besides the government policies by their very nature take a lot of time to develop and a lot of time to implement and so on. And when after 4 years or 5 years, maybe party changes, which is in power, and the previous work becomes useless.
Yes.
So there has to be continuity. I mean, interestingly, in dictatorial organizations, countries like China, like Mr. Putin, and like Mr. Lula in Brazil. So once they are in power, it's very difficult to destroy them because most of the devils of power are in their hands. Right? Hence, they can take a consistent stand, a long-term stand. And irrespective of Assad's own position, reps of China and Russia have taken a stand. And who is the big other country left? India, which has not taken a stand.
Yes, India's stand has been very astonishing for the world also, that they have not spoken at the time when it was expected from them.
Yeah, so now therefore looking at the evidence, that for 70 long years, Israel was not recognized by us. We kept on saying, like a Palestinian stand, that Palestinians should have a state. Before that, they cannot be a state. They should have been both state together. And Yasser Arafat, who was the first PLO, was very pally with Madam Indira Gandhi and used to come to India quite often, sometimes incognito, just to relax, you know, so on. So the relations were good. For democracy, if you talk about, we should support Palestine. If human rights you talk about, we should support them. Now it's all right, whatever your strategy may be, that 1,100 people had died or wounded, whatever it is, on October 7th. Well, the thing to do is to catch hold of those people. You boast of so much of intel and so on, and that you can go and pinpoint a person and then hit the rocket in the houses. Then you should have intel to identify who are these people.
Yeah, that is there, but there are other, I would say, geopolitical reasons also, because you don't want to tarnish your, tarnish may not be the right word, you don't want to hamper your relationships with a country like Israel, because you don't black and white that you are
who
supporting.
Says so? Who says so? Especially in our country and people like me who are just post independence born And we didn't feel any shackles of a foreign power or something of that kind. And say when we were 5 or 10 or something, we were participating ourselves still in the activities of promoting peace and promoting harmony. And therefore, India took a different approach. But India never said that, go ahead, Israel. They never said that. They only said that the rights of Palestinians to have their own home is as powerful, is as much required as it is for the Jews to have their homeland. Palestinians don't have any other homeland. So the whole community, you are saying, will not have their own home.
No, if we look at the world's views in large, most of the nations are in favor of this peace, and most of nations have talked about two-state theory. They have given consensus and they are in favor of two-state, that Palestinian and they should have, there should
since
be two.
Since we both also agree, we can go the next steps and discuss other people. So, the Palestinian ambassador to UN had stated, and the previous one as well as this one, he wept in emotion, an old man, wept with emotions. Girard, the representative of Jersey, had talked like Hitler. We don't care, as many people let them die, but we have to destroy Hamas. Now, this I keep on telling to my friends. There is a whole amount of media of US and Europe, DWS, coming to the balance also, there is government funded. So anyway, I see government funded by DWS, and then New Yorker, Washington Post, and so on. Now, despite all that, it all looks like there is a hypocrisy about it. US has kept on saying, oh, we have asked them to pursue Hamas, but to minimize the deaths of civilians. Now, how can you do it in this kind of technology? Second point, I'll take 2 minutes now. Second point, I was saying that the nature of war has changed. It's not hand-to-hand combat. And sitting at one place, you can shoot off a lot of rockets. Exactly. And so on. This is what Hamas
using
did.
AI.
And this is not even AI, I mean proper intelligence. Because AI wagara mein to wo log bhi ahead, you know, but there, as I had also discussed, that 300 rockets or drones, as they are claiming, would have been fired. It would have cost so much to Iran.
But Israel
would have, they're claiming. No, to that, it's a very interesting question. Nothing entered their territory except one bomb. Right? So how have they violated the airspace of Israel?
But the intel or the media, I'll not say intel, the media is saying there were 300 drones, 300 missiles.
Yeah,
and Israel,
because
of his own intel, was able to combat.
Hold it. Whether they were on a drill, whether they were going somewhere else, you can't prove the damn thing they need to come into Israel, right? Wait a minute. And democracy could have worked, diplomacy could have worked, they would have diverted them, but still you had the power to control them. What these people have done have shown a couple of things again, that Iran can overpower in intelligence what these guys are. How? I'll tell you what. Very cheap, inexpensive drones, $1,000 max. I had given the figures also. And the missiles which they would have been knocked off would be something like 10,000, 20,000, going up to 500,000 or something like that. Fine. So, as I said, this is a fight of equipment. Remember? It's not a hand-to-hand combat. Next time you will improve the frequency, the numbers, the places at which something is attacked, and be even more careful as far as the intelligence concerned. Maybe Iran will begin to lose out a bit on that, but perhaps not. Iranians are also very intelligent people.
Yes.
And in the armed thing, they have been since time, millennia, and nobody has actually come and ruled them.
Yes.
If you ask me. Okay, now, so it will be a fight of equipment to equipment. They say, who the hell cares? We have come to know exactly what the effects are. We have come to know exactly how many will do it. How many will steer away, how many will not steer away, etc. By the way, this is a generic factor I'm pinpointing now. that tomorrow's budgets of the armed forces have to go for such things. It's relatively simpler technology, therefore we should manufacture it ourselves. Right? The rate of manufacture of Iran is just like the rate of manufacture of tanks was for World War II by Russia to counter the tanks and the armed.
Here, Russia is also in favor of peace, where they themselves are in war with Ukraine. But when it comes to Israel and Palestine, yeah. Russia has also given a statement that they want peace and Israel should be condemned from these kind of massacres. And
so that's what the document says.
Yes, that's
the Russian ambassador saying it. That,
it's only tough. US who is just playing smart by saying that the language is not proper, the way it has been written in the resolution.
Well, whatever it might be, the rest of the world can accept the language and only one US.
That's what the US ambassador has said, that we cannot accept it because the language doesn't
suit us.
That's why we can't
And to England it suits, to France it suits, to Germany it suits.
That's what astonishing part is. That's
astonishing part is that, you know, how long democratic nations support genocide.
Yes.
It's serious stuff, ma'am. Other proper proceedings are done, they will also get pulled in.
Exactly. That's what we are trying to discuss, that when most of the world, even the nation, we discussed it last time also, that even a nation like Malta supported it and courageously coming in front, South Africa lady coming in front, then Slovenia supporting it. Then why a powerful nation to whom the whole world sees, is it not?
Now, let's summarize so far. U.S. stand. You have just mentioned some needs can be done. Everybody else starts with 7th October event and criticizes it and then goes on to immediately the humanitarian situation in Gaza and West Bank also, where the things of sustained life are not there. And on top of it, there are bombs. And from whatever data comes out from both sides, it seems that these are atrocities. And secondly, how do you compare the numbers of 1,100 odd died? Your statement, not mine. Israel is saying so, and you have killed 33,000 people. You don't claim that any children were affected there, and children are affected the most.
Yes.
And ladies.